is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. For our God is worthy to be praised. He's worthy from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. God's name is worthy to be praised. Come now, let us make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Let us enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting and his truth endureth to all generations. Dear God, we come into your presence on this third Sunday in the sixth month of this year to say thank you. You've been good to us. You brought us through dangers seen and unseen. You've kept us even in the midst of this pandemic season. You've been better to us than we've been to ourselves. We pause to let you know that we're grateful. We don't take your blessings for granted. We thank you because morning by morning, new mercies we have seen and all we have needed, your hands have provided. Your faithfulness has been great. And so we invoke your presence here with us today. God, you're welcome in this place. Come, Holy Spirit, come heavenly dove with all your quickening power and kindle a flame of sacred love in these hearts of ours. Now, God, we lift up this congregation, those of us who are present, those who are watching virtually. You know every need, every problem, every concern that we have. But we come serving notice on the adversary that our God is bigger than our problems. And so we cast our cares upon you because we know that you care for us. So God, where there's sickness, be a doctor. Where there's trouble, be a lawyer. Where there's confusion, be our peace. Help us, oh God, in these moments to be transformed by your presence and by your power. And when we would have gone down from this place, let there be no doubt that we've been in the presence of the Lord. No, God, we thank you for these candidates that will take you on by baptism. For they heard your word that declared that if thou wilt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thy heart that you have raised him from the dead, that they shall be saved. We pray, O God, that you will speak afresh and anew in their lives, and that they may know without a shadow of a doubt that they have your promise that if they walk with you, that they will not walk alone. Now, God, take charge of this service. Have your will and have your way. Throw your weight around to the end that when we would have left here, we will know that you are our God and we are your people. We praise you. We honor you. We magnify your name. We exalt you. We give you glory because there is no God like our God. Hear our prayer now. Incline your ear to us. It's in the only name that matters, the strong and powerful name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary.
To be baptized.
Take me to the water. Take me to the water. Take me to the water. To be
baptized.
None but the righteous.
have a tribute to fathers by William Long Jr.
Good morning, Salem. Tribute to the fathers. I want to take this opportunity to wish all dads and fathers a happy Father's Day. I salute all of you who realize that siring a child does not make you a father, but being present, providing love, provisions, and protection makes you a real dad. Thank you, Dad, for being present, providing love, provisions, and protection. Thank you, Dad, for taking me to school when I was not yet ready to go on my own or prepare to take public transportation. Thank you, Dad, for teaching me how to ride a bicycle and holding me up when I asked you to take the trailing wheels off. Thank you, Dad, for attending my ball games and graduations. Thank you, Dad, for encouraging me when I became discouraged and thought that the whole world was against me. I want to say thank you, Dad, for loving my mother and modeling me how to treat with respect and dignity the woman that will come into my life. Allow me to take this opportunity to salute all the uncles, granddads, cousins, and family friends that played the part of father when dad was absent, wandered away, or for other reasons could not be there. We also salute today all the mothers who've had to play both roles as mom and dad. Allow me to pause here to remember some of the dads who God has called from labor to reward and upon whose shoulders we stand. We remember today the Reverend Thomas J. Boyd, Deacon Robert Dodd, Deacon Charles Taylor, Deacon Lloyd White, Deacon Charles Hammond, Deacon Hiawatha Adams, and so many more whom time nor memory allow us to mention at this time. We remember and thank God for all the love and values that you gave and taught us. We also want to remember those whose fathers had been called to the heavenly reward. We pray that sweet memories of their love and teaching ring today as a sweet melody in your heart. I want to say happy Father's Day to the best dad in the world, Deacon William Long Sr. Thank you, Pastor James Thornton, for being a father to all of us. We love you and respect you. Salem, won't you join me now and give a standing ovation to all the dads in our church to show them that we love them and thank God for each of them.
We have is mine.
Victory is mine.
Victory is mine.
Victory is mine.
Victory today.
Praise him right now. Come on, praise him right now. Hallelujah this morning.
Church,
I love to praise
him.
I love to praise him.
praise His name.
I love to praise Him.
I love to praise His name. I love to praise His name.
I love to praise.
Let's praise him.
Praise him.
Ooh.
Praise him.
Oh.
Jesus.
What a sweet name.
Bless his Savior.
He's worthy.
He's worthy to be praised.
Come on.
Praise him.
You feel like praising him this morning?
Praise him.
Praise him. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Sweet Jesus.
Bless his Savior.
He's a Savior.
He's worthy to be praised.
From the rising.
From the rising of the sun.
Can I get a witness?
Unto the going down of the stairs.
So we know that he's worthy.
He's worthy.
Let's give God praise for what God has done. He's worthy to be praised from the rising of the sun. God's name is worthy to be praised. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is in me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits towards us. I'll bless the Lord, not just sometimes, but I'll bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. We have tasted and we know that the Lord is good. He's worthy to be praised from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. God's name is worthy to be praised. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Lord, we love you, we praise you, and we give you glory. I learned something. As I was perusing previous baptisms, and that we have been doing something wrong for years. We normally say we want to present our baptismal certificates to our candidates, but they're not candidates. They were candidates for baptism. They have been baptized. So we want to present these certificates to our new members. So I'm delighted. I love this lady. She don't know. She's somebody that will keep you straight. Help me celebrate and congratulate Ms. Terry Morris. It's been my pleasure during this pandemic season to share both virtually and in person with our candidates. Miss Tiffany Lanier. Miss Kayla McCoy. And Miss Rona Ackham. Let's thank God for our new members. I do suggest that you keep your baptismal certificates, you put them in a safe place. Sometimes they can be helpful to you when you can't find a birth certificate or you need proof or a document that you belong to the family of God. We thank God and we're excited for what God has done. We're probably one of the few churches that are having or have had a baptismal experience in the midst of a pandemic season. But our God is awesome and he can do anything but fail. Few notices and announcements very, very quickly as we move on expeditiously with the rest of our service. Let me thank our music ministry for a job well done. Glad to have all of our young people here singing today. Glad to have Miss Courtney back. Notice the announcements as follows. We said goodbye to one of our faithful members on this past Friday, Sister Jean Williams, and those services were held at the Caribe Funeral Home on Friday evening. I want to thank Dr. Betty Holly for taking care of the graveside services on yesterday. I ask that you continue to pray for that family. On Wednesday, of course, please meet us for Bible study and prayer meeting on this Wednesday at 7 o'clock. Also, of course, we'll be looking for you for our worship experience, which will be on Sunday, as it always is. You can invite a friend to join us. We thank God that the numbers and the transmission rate as it relates to the pandemic are less than 1% in New York at this time. We give God praise for what God has done. Let me thank Brother Master William Long Jr. for giving the tribute to the fathers this morning. He read it better than I wrote it. A wonderful, wonderful job. Thank all of you, and again, I want to wish all of our fathers a happy Father's Day. If you have a good man in your life and he's been supportive and been there for you, try to show him some love. Is my sister Brenda here today? Brenda, thank you for the most beautiful red roses that you sent your brother.
Let's give him some praise. Always, let's give him some praise. You can put your hands together. Enter his gates.
Enter his gates with thanksgiving.
Enter his courts.
Enter his courts with praise.
Enter his gates.
Enter his gates with thanksgiving.
Enter his courts.
Enter his courts with praise.
Be thankful.
Be thankful unto him.
Thankful unto him.
Thankful unto him.
Thankful unto him. Your hands together. I know you can't sing, but you can put your hands together. Come on, give the Lord a clap. Enter his gates.
Enter his gates.
Yeah.
With thanksgiving.
Enter his courts.
Enter his courts. With praise.
Enter his gates.
Enter his gates. With
thankful.
Thankful unto him.
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 And bless.
And bless.
Give him some praise. Did you come to give him some praise? We come to praise.
We come to praise his name.
We come.
We come to praise his name.
We come.
We come to praise his name.
We come to praise his name.
We come to praise his name.
Early in the morning.
We come to praise his name.
We come to praise.
We come to praise his name.
We come to praise.
We come to praise his name.
Somebody got a praise in you. You just need to get it out. It's all right to give God praise, honor, and glory. When we think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for us, we've got to give him praise. God has been good. God woke us up this morning, started us on our way, gave us another chance. We've come to bless his name. We've come to let him know that we love him. We come to let him know that we appreciate him. We have a song that the angels cannot sing, for they know nothing of sin and his sting, but we've been redeemed by the precious blood of the Lamb. God, we love you, we praise you, we honor you, and we give you glory. The grass withereth and the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Our lesson for the morning is found in the Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 1, verses 1 through. I'll stop at verse 12. Hear now the word of the Lord. I'm reading this morning out of the NIV version of the Bible. Hear now the word of the Lord. The beginning of the gospel about Jesus Christ, the Son of God. It is written in Isaiah the prophet, I will send my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way. A voice of one crying in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. And so John came baptizing in the desert region and preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sin. The whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem went out to him, confessing their sins. They were baptized by him in the Jordan River. John wore clothing made of camel's hair and a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. And this was his message: after me will come one more powerful than I, the thongs of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. At that time, Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. As Jesus was coming up out of the water, he saw heaven being torn open and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven: "You are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased." At once the Spirit sent him into the desert, and he was in the desert 40 days, being tempted by Satan. He was with wild animals, and angels attended him. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Yes, I believe.
Yes, I believe.
Everybody, yes, I believe.
Yes, I believe. All things are possible if you only believe.
Yes, I believe.
Been talking about all year, well, no, during the men have had chats every week. We talk about certain things, but on this particular evening, it came up that we should do something and not let this Father's Day be that much different from any other Father's Day, because we have done this. We have done Father's Day for years and years. As a matter of fact, I missed breakfast this morning because that's something that we always have. But it came up with the idea that since we have a person here with us, among us, who has been from the worst of the pandemic to, at this point, what was just mentioned, less than 1% effective now, we just can't be, we'll just be remiss if we don't do something to honor that person. So it's my privilege and it's an honor to present this plaque to the inspirational father of this church for this year. So we said, well, Reverend Thornton, we would like to do this for you. It's something that's never been done before. I see I'm a little nervous, but it's never been done before, but we'd like to present this plaque to you, Reverend Thornton, that says, please. I'm not gonna hurt you right now. Senior Layman Council of Salem Missionary Baptist Church recognizes Pastor James Arthur Thornton as the Inspirational Father of the Year, June 20th, 2021. So I like this.
Rejoice today.
with you. Yes, Lord, I agree with you. Yes, Lord. For those of you that might be going through a storm right now, for those of you that feel that you're doing it all on your own, that your friends have walked out on you, and you can't seem to find your way, I want to tell you this morning, press your way through. Press your way through. Even though you feel like giving up, press your way through. Press your way through. Oh, press your way through. You've come too far to give up now. Press your way through. You see, even though sometimes it gets rough, so you'll have to pray your way through. Hallelujah. Pray your way through. Even though you feel like giving up, pray your way through. Pray your way through. Pray your way through. 'Cause God's got something waiting for you if you pray your way through. Now, I know it gets even rough sometimes, so there's nothing wrong late at night when you might have to, listen, cry your way through. Oh, I wish I could get a witness. Cry your way through. Even though I know nobody understands, you can cry your way through. Cry your way through. Cry your way through. You've come much too far to turn around now. Just cry your way through. Oh, I wish I could get a witness this morning. I said, I wish I could get a witness this morning. Maybe it's just me, Pastor. I wish I could get a witness this morning. Press your way through. Oh, press your way through. Even though I know it's hard sometimes, but you gotta press your way through. Press your way through. Oh, Lord. Press your way through. You've come too far to give up now. Press your way through. 'Cause God's got something waiting for you if you press your way through. You gotta keep on through the storm. God, He will never leave you alone. You must press your way through. Said He'll walk with you, He'll talk with you, He'll be right there. Don't worry, you press your way through. Hallelujah. 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 Keep on, keep on, keep on.
Hallelujah.
I want you to show some love to Brother Michael Walker. Came to see me this week and he said, Pastor, I've been with you from the very beginning. When we had no praise team, no music ministry, we had Michael Walker and Lydia. But he said, since Miss Courtney is back with our young people, that he's gonna take a break. I want them to know that we appreciate him. Of course, now we're not gonna just let him go like that because I can't sing. So he will be here the first Sunday and then he'll sing with the men on the fourth Sunday. And then whenever I need somebody to sing, I feel like going on. Though trials come on every hand, I feel like going on. And as he was singing Pressure Way Through, I thought about the Apostle Paul wrote to the church that he loved so dearly, the Philippian church, and said, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are before, I press. Means there's going to be some opposition, there's going to be some challenges, it's not going to be easy, but I'm going to press my way through. I press towards the mark of the prize of the high calling which I have in Jesus Christ. And then, I don't know about you, but I'm gonna take back what the devil is trying to steal from me. I'm gonna take back my joy, take back my freedom, take back my peace, take back my love, take back my health, take back my strength, take back my money, take back my friends, take back my resources, because greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us and gives us the victory. Well, let me move on to the task at hand. We're not going to keep you long, don't worry. You'll be on your way home soon. But since we're here, since we made it, we may as well just give God praise, honor, and glory. Do you know how many folk didn't make it in this pandemic season? And not everybody lost their life because of the virus. Some people God just took out. Some people in car accidents. I drove on Thursday to Philadelphia, went to preach with for a friend of mine, my friend Brian Jenkins, and he has a homeless ministry. You talk about somebody who loves the homeless. I mean, I saw ministry in a different way. We went to Maggiano's, and I got off my diet, and I had filet mignon medallions with onions and mushrooms. Brian ate all of his. I couldn't eat all of mine. I said, Brian, I just can't. He said, don't worry about it. He had them pack up my pasta and my steak. And the homeless man was sleeping. And Brian wakes up the homeless man. Say, I got some dinner for you. Man woke up with a smile. That's ministry. Not stepping over the least of them. Where would any of us be if God didn't take time and wake us up, pick us up, turn us around, and give us another chance? Consecrate me now to thy service, Lord, by the power of your grace divine. Let my soul look up with a steadfast hope and my will be lost in thine. Draw me nearer and nearer, precious Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Now, O God, allow the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart to be found acceptable in thy sight. It's in the strong name of Jesus the Christ we pray. Amen. I want to talk from this thought very, very quickly. God, our model father. God, our model father. If you want to learn how to be a really good father, then we need to look at God, our Heavenly Father. Jesus had been in obscurity. He had not yet made his public appearance. And I want to suggest that sometimes God will hide you in order to protect you. And God moves in God's own time. Here in the text that I read in your hearing, we have John the Baptist. John the Baptist is the first cousin of Jesus. You remember when Jesus was conceived in the womb of Mary. Mary went to visit her aunt Elizabeth. And the Bible says in Luke chapter 1 that Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste into the city of Judea. She entered into the house of Zacharias and saluted Elizabeth. And it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. And she spake with a loud voice and said, blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. And whence is it that the mother of my Lord should come to me? And they began to rejoice. And she said, blessed is she that believed, for God shall do great things. And then Mary started shouting and said, my soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in my Savior, for he that is mighty hath done great things. And so what I want to suggest to you, that it was at the point of conceivement that John and Jesus came together and to know each other even before they were born. It was preordained that John would be the forerunner of Jesus. Allow me to pause parenthetically and say that when God shows up, however he shows up, you ought to give him some praise. You ought to give him some glory. Every now and then, as friends, you ought to get together and just decide, you know what, we're not going to talk about anybody today. We're not going to gossip. We're just going to spend some time praising the Lord because he's worthy to be praised. Mark says that in the beginning of the gospel of Jesus Christ, as is written in the prophets, behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare the way. And John only had one job. And you need to understand that John the Baptist in those days was more popular than Jesus. John was so good that part of his name became what he did. John the Baptist. I remember one time I baptized about 14 candidates at one time, and I came home and Angela said, welcome, James the Baptist. And John had only one job, and he said that I'm just a voice crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way, make straight the way of the Lord. And John knew his responsibility. John knew his job. John stayed on his track. He was not jealous of Jesus. He just did what God told him to do, and that was simply to cry aloud and let people know that Jesus was coming. John says, I indeed baptize you with water, but when Jesus shows up, he is mightier than I, and untie his shoes. But when he shows up, he is going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost. God is now calling Jesus on the stage to begin his ministry, to begin the work that God had preordained for him. Now, I want to suggest that some of us grow impatient and we move in our own time. We do what we want to do when we want to do it. But I want to suggest to you this morning that it pays to wait on God, because God's time is the right time. I heard Isaiah, as I was putting this together, says, has thou not known, has thou not heard, the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. Even the youth, like William Long Jr., will get weary, and young men will utterly fall. But I know this to be true. They that wait upon the Lord, they that can serve the Lord in good times and bad times, serve him when you're up and serve him when you're down, serve him when you're sick and serve him when you're well, serve him in the midst of a pandemic, serve him when there is no pandemic, just serve him because he's worthy, then he will renew your strength. And some people wonder how you make it, and you don't have to wonder. You know that it was the Lord that was on your side. I know that we wouldn't be here today only because of the grace and the mercy of God. You can't make me doubt him because I know too much about him. He'll renew your strength. And Isaiah says, you'll run and you won't get weary. You'll walk and you won't faint. I'm almost done. And it came to pass, in those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and went and said to John, I want to be baptized. Another translation says that John was reluctant, but Jesus says to him, suffer it to be so. And this is why, candidates, why we baptize the way we do. I know some people baptize with sprinkling. I know that some people baptize in the name of Jesus, but we don't follow what Peter said. Peter preached one sermon, I wish that was me, and 5,000 folk joined the church. There's no special time that you have to have baptism. You can have baptism whenever God says so. And if we had 5,000 people join the church at one time, we could have baptism every day. We can have baptism on a Wednesday night. Because wherever God is and wherever God tells you to do, it pays to be obedient to God. But look at the text. Jesus was baptized by immersion because the Bible says in verse 10 that Jesus was baptized of John in the Jordan River, and straightway coming up out of the water. So that meant that John put him down. He came straight up out of the water, and the heavens opened, and the Spirit like a dove descended upon him. This is the first evidence that we have of the Trinity. We see here the Holy Spirit that descends on Jesus' shoulder in the form of a dove. We have God who speaks and says, this is my beloved Son, in him I am well pleased. And we have the voice of God. I don't know about you, but sometimes he walks with me, and sometimes he talks with me, and every now and then he lets me know that I'm his and he is mine. All right, Reverend, how is God our model father? Here it is. God says to Jesus, you are. He affirms him. A father must affirm his children. What is an affirmation? The affirmation is that something exists to declare that it's true. Fathers, we have the responsibility to affirm our children. I don't know what you will be, but I do know that you are. I know that you are real. The fact that the Bible says, and God speaks and says, you are, is a form of the verb to be. That is the same word when God speaks to Moses, and Moses is commanded to go to Pharaoh and tell Pharaoh to let my people go. And Moses says, well, who should I say sent you? And God says, say that I am. But what is your last name? I am that I am. And so you need to know that your child is, and that child can be whatever God wants him to be, because God is. God is water when you get thirsty. He's a way out of no way. I heard him say, I am the good shepherd. I am the way. I am the truth. I am the light. I am darkness. I am light in dark places. I am a way out of no way. I am the lily of the valley. I am the bright and morning star. I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am the first and the last. I am he that was and is and ever shall be. I'm God all by yourself. All by myself. You've got to affirm that your child, whether it's a girl or a boy, that that child is. That child may become a doctor, may become a lawyer, may become an architect, may become a musician, but that child is. We have to affirm our children, and all children need to be affirmed by their father. And so here is Jesus coming down to the Jordan River to be baptized. And God speaks and says, you are. Secondly, if you take your notes, a father identifies with their children. A father gives their children identification. We must own our children. That is why children take or should be given the last name of the father. My son is Isaiah James Thornton because I'm his father. Now, if you don't take care of your responsibility and you just sire the child, then you don't have the right to give the child your last name. Now, these children don't come into the world by themselves. The mother does not bear the son by herself like Jesus was born by immaculate conception. And even Joseph had a problem when he learned that Mary was pregnant, and Mary said that this thing was of the Holy Ghost. The Bible says that Joseph was mindful to put her away. They said, you need to stone her. I mean, I've never heard of anything about a child being born by immaculate conception. Apparently, Joseph was not a black man because a black man would have knocked Mary out. But Joseph took some time. And when you don't know what to do, what you need to do is just go to the Lord in prayer. What a friend we have in Jesus. All of our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. Children need to be connected to family, and they need to be identified with their fathers. That's why in the Bible, it's the father that gives the child the name. The Bible says that when Jesus was born, that God spoke and said that his name shall be called Jesus. It was Zacharias, because they wanted to call him Zacharias Jr., and they had struck Zacharias dumb, because he did not believe that God could do what God could do. And so when the child was born, they wanted to call him Zacharias Jr., and they had to give his father a tablet, and he wrote, his name shall be John. And at that point, God opened his mouth and he began to speak and praise God. One of the reasons that children will join a gang is because they need to be connected to family and they don't feel they have a place to be identified with. And so they're seeking family. And so it's very important that fathers give their children identification. So if you take your notes, a good father affirms their children. They may not do what you want them to do the way you want them to do it, but you have to give them the opportunity to march to their own drumbeat without giving up your position as the authority figure in the household. My son came to me one day and said, Daddy, I'm going to be Muslim. I said, you can be Muslim, be anything you want to be. But if you decide to be Muslim, just let me know where you're going to live, because you're not going to live here. Because as for me and my house, we gonna serve the Lord. We believe that Jesus died, that God raised him from the dead on the third day morning, and that he got up with all power in his hands, that he ascended and sits on the right hand of the Father, ever making intercessions for you and me. And everything I have comes from God. It's God that gave me this house. It's God that gave me this job. It's God that gave me this education. All that I have comes from him. And so, fathers, let's not give up our authority in the household. You can be a musician, but you still got to know that I'm the head of this house. I'm almost done. And then finally, a father gives commendation to their children. Jesus says, God says, you are my beloved son. in whom I am well pleased. At this juncture, Jesus has not healed anybody. He has not raised the dead. He has not fed 5,000. However, God commends him just for his presence. Allow your child to know that you are proud of him or her. Ronald Bertrand sent me a letter to let me know that his daughter made the dean's list and that she's going to have an assignment. What do they call those kind of assignments? What's the word I want, Angie? An internship. That she's going to get an internship. And he just wanted me to know that he was proud of her. Daughters need to know that dad loves her and that dad is proud of her. A daughter ought to be able to pick a good man by the way the father treats her mother. As a man, you ought not be fussing at your wife and smacking her around. She ought to do something good sometimes. Baby, you know, you burnt the toast, but I scraped it off, and it don't taste too bad. I mean, every now and then, you got to make them feel good about whatever. They need to know that you love them. A father ought to be the kind of man that the daughter will look for in her husband. I'm concluding now, and so if you want to be a good father, and God shows us what a good father is like, because a good father will affirm his child. A good father will identify and own that child. I don't know how it is that when these men, and we got to teach them that if they plant the seed, they too have a responsibility to take care of that they help to produce. They ought not have the opportunity just to walk away like they didn't do anything, and the mama's got to carry the child for 9 months and bring that child into the world by herself, and we let the brothers off the hook. We cannot let these brothers off the hook. They've got to stand up and be a man. If they can do the thing, then they got to be able to take care of business. And you sisters ought to be careful not to let these brothers into the promised land. If they ain't got no job, they can't even buy you a hamburger from McDonald's. You got to tell them to take a walk. And I wouldn't have no brother walking with me with his pants all the way down by his behind. I saw one man, he was running for the bus and his pants fell down around his ankle and he almost tripped and fell and couldn't even help the woman that was following him. We've got to tell these boys that now are we the sons and daughters of God, and it does not yet appear what it shall be, but when he shall appear, we shall be like him. We've got to teach and preach that holiness is still right, that the blood still saves, that the wages of sin is death, and the gift of God is eternal life. We've got to be the kind of men that will affirm our family. We've got to be the kind of men that will identify with our family so that they know that God loves them and that we as children of God will take care of our business. And then we've got to commend them and let them know that we love them. I'm done now. And how do we know that God loves us? Because the Bible says that you can give and not love, but you cannot love and not give, because God so loved the world. I'm so glad that he loves me. You could put your name there. Oh, there's a wonder at sunrise and sunset. There's a wonder of wonders I see. But the wonder that thrills my soul is the wonder that God loves me. And so even if your earthly father is a little shaky, he's not all that you would need him to be, I want you to know that I've got a father who sits high and looks low, that he takes care of me, that he walks with me, he talks with me, and every now and then he lets me know that I'm his and he is mine. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him, Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Help thou my unbelief. We've got to get to the place that we believe this, only believe. I come to tell you that all things, preach, James, all things, you don't hear what I say, all things are possible. If you only believe, who's ever believed in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hallelujah. I know that we'd like to think that we're going to live and never die, but I want you young people to know that you got to take advantage of this time. Take advantage of the morning time of your life. I say this at every funeral. That's why the Bible says, Lord, teach me to number my days, that I may apply my heart unto wisdom, because the time will come that God will call us off the stage of life. The Bible says a man's days are 70, and if by reason of measure they be 80, yet is there labor and sorrow. We've got to make sure, young people, that we help take care of older folk, because all you have to do is keep on living. You won't keep looking like that. You won't keep looking like that Tatafe. The time will come that you won't look like a pencil, but you'll look more like a huge pretzel, because time brings about a change. There was a time I had a six pack, but now I got a half a gallon. But I want you to know that as we get older, every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. And when this earthly house of this tabernacle be dissolved, I've got another building, one not made with hands, but eternal into heaven. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish. And when this time is over, I'm going to step into eternal life. And when I see my heavenly father, I'm going to thank him for how he's brought me. Thank him for how he's taught me. Thank him that he's never left me. I'm going to give him the praise, the honor, and the glory, because he's worthy to be praised. Give God praise, honor, and glory. God said, this is my son. I tell Isaiah, when you're good, you're my son. When you're bad, you're still my son. When you act crazy, you're still my son. I'm so glad that God won't divorce us, that his love is unconditional, that in spite of us, that God loves us. So whoever you are, I want you to know on this Father's Day that God loves you. Because Christ came not into the world to condemn the world, that the world through him might be saved. In the name of the Father, name of the Son, name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And then what I like about it, Terry, is that you can come to him just as you are. And when you come to him, he has a way of fixing you up. When you come to him, you'll pull your pants up. You'll, Jesus, I'm coming. You get yourself straight. You can come just as you are without one plea. Doors at church are open. If you're here, won't you come? Last verse, just as I am.
Just as I am, my love, my own, has broken
every barrier down.
Every barrier down.
And now to be thine.
Now to be thine.
And thine alone. God bless you. Anybody glad you came to church today? What better way to let God know that we love him and we appreciate God's greatest gift given to us than to celebrate now the Holy Communion? Prior to doing that, won't you help me trying to figure out how to do this, because we've never done this before, and nobody else has ever done it before either, because they've never been in a pandemic before. They've never come through a situation like this. But God has a way of making a way out of no way. So we said, well, okay, how will we recognize our new members? What I want us to do is that in terms of thanking God for our new members and letting them know that we love them and we appreciate them and they're welcome into their new families, we want to stand and give them a huge ovation. Won't you do that? And we praise God for each of you. So we are your new family. Some of us look good, some of us don't look so good, some of us are skinny, some of us are fat, but we your family. You got folk like that in your family. You know, got Uncle Jake that comes over. I remember my Uncle Doc. He said, Jimmy, stand back. Put some kerosene on the fires. That's the fire. God bless you. We're delighted to have you. Also, let me take this opportunity to thank you, Julius, and the brothers for remembering and thinking of me on this day. I am humbled at your presentation. Thank you so very, very much. Let us prepare now to hear out of God's word. Adversary is always trying to put our light out, but God's light will never go out. Jesus says, I am the light of the world. He that followeth after me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. Jesus said unto them, ye are the lights of the world. City is set upon a hill that cannot be hid, neither do men light their candles and put them under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine that men and women and boys and girls might see your good works. Glorify our Father, which is in heaven. The Bible says that after the supper, Jesus took bread and gave thanks and said, this is my body, which is broken for you. Likewise, he took the cup and said, this is my blood, which is shed for you. That as often as ye eat of my flesh and drink of my blood, ye do show forth my death and my suffering till I shall come again. On this Father's Day, I'd like to invite the chair of our deacon board, Deacon William Long, to give the prayer over the bread, and the chair lady of our deaconess board, Deaconess Antoinette Winslow, to give prayer over our cup.
Our Father and our God, we thank you, Lord, for allowing us to come before your table one more time. Despite our shortcomings, despite our missteps, despite falling short of the mark, you allow us one more time to get it right. And we thank you, Father. We thank you for your dominion and your leadership over our lives. Father, we ask that you take this simple bread and move it from a common use and transform it into a spiritual use. Allow it to be ingested in our bodies and remind us of the life, the death, and the resurrection and the ascension of our soon coming King, Jesus the Christ. We thank you, Father. We love you, and we can't do it without you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
There is a fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins. And sinners plunge beneath that flood, lose all their guilty stains. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, blessed is thy holy name. We thank you for another opportunity to gather in remembrance and celebration of the blood, redemptive blood that was shed on Calvary's cross. We thank you, Father God, because now we have the opportunity to have eternal life. We are no longer shackled with death, sin, and destruction, and for this we are grateful. Father God, we ask that you will take this common grape juice and transform it spiritually so that we can reflect on the shed blood of thy only begotten Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Come. Where are you going? Just wait right there.
Your heart does not.
And after the supper, he took bread. Prayerfully, we have it opened. He blessed, gave to his disciples. Let's eat together. For he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. Chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Amen. Likewise, after the supper, he took the cup. When you have it open, say amen. Oh, y'all are doing good. Let's drink together. Dear God, how we thank you for one more time allowing us to gather together around your table of love. Thank you, God, for loving us, for affirming us, for identifying with us, allowing us to know that we are your children and you are our God. Thank you for commending us and encouraging us. Keep us together now, O God, in the bond of love and unity. Let us hear the Apostle Paul, who declares that we will let nothing separate us from the love of God, which we have in Christ Jesus. Bless, O God, this congregation, those of us that are gathered here, those of us who are gathered at home. Keep us, O God, together in the bond of love, reminding us that out of one blood have you created all of us to dwell together in unity. Hear our prayer now. Incline your ear to us. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. We're on our way home. Again, we want to wish all of our fathers a happy Father's Day. Can y'all show some love to the fathers? We're not getting too much love, brothers, but that's okay. Can y'all try that one more time? Thank you. Your brothers need a little love. Thank you so much for being here. Let us do our offertory prayer. And then what happens is our trustees will be at the back, and we ask that you leave your offering on your way out. Thank you so much for being here today. It's good to see you, all of you. Please come back next week. I'll be here. I ain't got nowhere else to go. Let's pray. Dear God, for the privilege now of being able to give back to you a portion of that you've given us, but recognize that all things come from you and you allow us to give you back a portion of that you've given us. Bless each person that will make a sacrifice, that will give in our building renovation offering, that will give in tithes and offerings, that will give to bless your servant. May these gifts aid in bringing your kingdom just a little bit closer on earth in the hearts of men and women and boys and girls. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray, from whom all things come. Now, new members, family, I want you to wait here. Let me say goodbye, and then I'm going to come. I want to get a picture, because this is a historic occasion.
Amen.
Nobody in the world has had an occasion like this. God bless each of you. God bless all of you. And choir, what are we going to do? We're going to go tell the world we found a Savior, and he's sweet. We know. And now unto him who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, keep you perfect in every good work, working in you and through you, that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus the Christ, to whom be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever.